Hello everyone. Our topic for presentation is Frame Relay and ATM. These are my group members. Now, what is Frame Relay and ATM? Frame Relay is high performance WAN protocol that operates at physical data link layer of OSI reference model. Frame Relay is based on packet switching technology, where ATM is an asynchronous transfer mode, is a switching technology used for telecommunication networks that uses asynchronous time division multiplexing to encode data into small fixed size cells. Now, what is Frame Relay? Frame Relay is high performance WAN protocol that operates at physical and data link layer of OSI reference model. Frame Relay originally was designed for use across integrated services, digital network, that is ISDN interfaces. Frame Relay is based on packet switch technology. Here, why we are using Frame Relay? Frame Relay is a packet switching telecommunication services designed for a cost efficient data transmission for intermittent traffic between local area network LANs and between endpoints in wide area network, that is WAN. Our objective is to explain key features of Frame Relay and to explain and to specify the Frame Relay format. Frame Relay is an example of packet switch technology. The following techniques are used in packet switching technology, that is variable length packets and statistical multiplexing. Variable length packets are used for more efficient and flexible data transfer. These packets are switched between the various segments in the network until the destination is reached, where statistical multiplexing techniques control network access in packet switch network. The advantage of this technique is that it accommodates more flexibility and more efficient use of bandwidth. The image for Frame Relay is shown here. This image consists of 3DT, that is Nagpur, Pune, Mumbai, and 4DC, that is A, B, C, D, are interconnected with each other. What is DTE and what is DCE? DTE is data terminal equipment and DCE is data circuit terminating equipment. DTEs are generally considered to be terminating equipment for specific network and typically are located on the premises for a customer. In fact, they may be owned by the customer. Example of DT devices are terminals, personal computer, routers and bridges. DC are carrier owned internet working devices. The purpose of DC equipment is to provide clocking and switching services in a network, which are the devices that actually transmit data through the WAN. In most cases, these are packet switches. The connection between DTE devices and DCE devices consists of both physical layer component in a link and a link layer component. Physical component defines a mechanical, electrical, functional, and procedural specification for the connection between the devices. One of the most commonly used physical layer interface specification is the recommended standard, that is RS-232 specification. The link layer component defines the protocol that establishes the connection between the DCE devices such as router, the DCE devices such as switch. The image showing two PVCs from Nagpur to Mumbai and second from Mumbai to Pune. Now, what is PVC? PVC is permanent virtual circuits, are permanently established connections that are used to that are used for frequent and consistent data transfer between DT devices across the Frame Relay network. Communication across PVC does not require the call setup and the termination state that are used for the SVCs. Now we are going to see what is ATM. Now, ATM is an asynchronous transfer mode is an ITUT, that is International Telecommunication Union Telecommunication Standard for Cell Relay. ATM is a connection-oriented high-speed, low-delay switching and transmission technology that uses short and fixed-size packets called cells to transport information. And ATM integrates the multiplexing and switching function. The most basic service building block is the ATM virtual circuit, which is an end-to-end connection that has been defined endpoints and routes, but does not have bandwidth dedicated to it. ATM is originally the transfer mode of implementing broadband ISDN, that is BISDN, but it is also implemented in a non-ISDN environment where very high data rates are required. ATM is well suited for burst traffic and allows communication between devices that operate at frequent speed. These are the ATM asynchronous transfer mode images showing how data can be transmitted. ATM is an asynchronous transfer mode. The information for multiple services types such as voice, video, data is conveyed in a small and fixed size data. ATM networks are connection oriented. ATM integrates the multiplexing and switching function. The most basic service building blocks in the ATM virtual circuits, which is an end-to-end connection that has defined end-to-end points and routes but does not have bandwidth. Oh my God. He bold it in a minute. Jump.
Abhi? Of course, of course.
Say, wait, kaise karna?
Of course.
मैं मेरे को बता, हाँ छोड़ दो,
हाँ गलती ये हुई।